time now for our focus report, and today we're looking at corrupt practices which the South African president has blamed for the country's economic woes. Since taking office, Cyril Ramaphosa has been a man on a mission, determined to put a stop to state capture. Jacob Zuma's close links to the Indian Gupta brothers, who bagged billions in business from state-owned enterprises, is at the centre of this entire saga. Our correspondents Caroline Dumais and Stefan Carstens have sent this report.
Optimum Colliery was once a leading company in the South African coal sector. But this mine, located in the province of Mpumalanga, has been placed under business rescue, like many other mines in the country. Miners regularly embark on strikes, and the South African government is forced to pay for social peace through handouts. Their union leader, Richard, makes sure that workers continue to exert pressure.
They are more relieved now that at least the minister have confirmed that they're not going to lose their jobs. It's going to make everything possible to save the situation. So there's a bit of a relief, but there's still the scare of a bit that if you are dealing with these shareholders that you're dealing with, anything is possible. All of these people that are sitting behind me here are very anti-Gupta.
The Guptas are an Indian-born family whose name is now associated with corruption. Their partnership with Duduzane, Jacob Zuma's son, caused much controversy. The family's strong ties to the former president allegedly helped them to build an empire through public tenders. In Cape Town, several parliamentary committees have set up investigation teams. Richard is attending the Mining Commission of Inquiry. Optimum is not the only company being investigated. Four other Gupta-linked mines went bankrupt. Gwede Mantashe, the Minister of Mineral Resources, is personally taking care of the matter.
I always tell people that mining is not for speculators. And if you're in a hurry to get money, you're going to do things that are strange. You're going to actually reap and harvest the mine before time for harvesting has arrived. And I think we're dealing with that situation here today.
The Guptas did not only own coal mines, they were also instrumental in the running of the state-owned company Eskom. The National Electricity Power Utility was run by Brian Molefe, who turned out to be a protege of the Indian family. Their ties have led to widespread claims of state capture, alleging that the Guptas benefited directly from state enterprises. When the plot was uncovered, Brian Molefe broke down in tears.
The president did not even know anything about it, as far as I'm concerned. And he calls for his resignation, I think, out of line. I will resign before he does.
Eskom's top management was eventually removed. As the company faces significant challenges, the utility's debt is sitting at over 25 billion euros. The truth would have never been uncovered without the tireless work of local journalists. Gupta Leaks, a collaborative investigation into state capture, broke the silence on the Guptas' empire. Thousands of mails brought evidence in all sectors, mining, transport and agriculture, to show that the political elite were engaged in corrupt practices.
A lot of the scandals that the Gupta Leaks shed light on are not new scandals. We've known about them for a long time. What the Gupta Leaks have done is to add to the case against the Guptas and their acolytes and a lot of politicians and public officials as well.
South Africans waited in anticipation for Cyril Ramaphosa to take over from Jacob Zuma in February 2018. The new head of state has never hidden his will to stop corruption.
In the end, it is the ethical behavior that our people look forward to, so much your legal arguments and how clever you are. It is how you deport yourself, how you demonstrate that you care. Your moral uprightness is what our people look out for.
Today, justice is taking its course. Trials involving the Guptas and their accomplices are ongoing. The opposition is relieved.
We are not going to allow South Africa to be sold over a plate of curry. We're not part of that mess.
Over the years, the Guptas have become South Africa's most notorious family.
Go Guptas! Go Guptas! Go Guptas!
The Guptas' assets are valued at 6 billion euros, but the family denies it.
We are the very small, Stephen, that we already been saying many times that we are in a not more than a 1% of the stock exchange of this country.
AJ Gupta had to fly to Dubai to avoid arrest.
So how you can presume
the end of Jacob Zuma's tenure as South Africa's president was also the end of the Guptas' reign. The Indian family is no longer untouchable.